You're watching West Hartford Community Television.
You're watching West Hartford Community Television.
For the community, by the community.
Get ready to find hope. Get ready to be inspired. Get ready to discover your full potential. Get ready for total success. From the Total Success Coach, Princess Bola Adelani.
Hi, this is Princess Bola Adelani, the Total Success Coach, welcoming you to Inspired Success, your monthly dose of inspiration power, the program that equips you with the power and inspiration for total success. That is success at work and in life. It's November already. Countdown to 2011 has begun. Less than 60 days to the end of 2010. And if you're like me, you're thinking to yourself, you know, you're freaking out and thinking, you know, where has this year gone? Another year is about to bite the dust. And despair might be setting in. You know, where are my dreams? Where are those visions? What about those goals I set for myself at the beginning of the year? I'm yet to move forward. I'm yet to achieve. I'm yet to accomplish my dreams. And it's already over. Well, if you're in that situation, this program today is for you. Don't you touch that dial. Honestly, I'm serious. I have good news for you. It's not over till it's over, and it's not over yet. You can still finish 2010 strong. Yes, that's what I said. I said you can still finish the year 2010 strong. And the focus of this broadcast today is to teach you, is to equip you with the strategies and the principles to finish strong. Okay? So like I always like to say, position yourself, get ready, get your notepad and your pen. Call your friend, call your neighbor, put on your DVD, because I'm telling you, it's going to be informational, inspirational, and transformational. 2010, yes, this great year. How do you finish strong, Princess Bola, you're probably asking. One of the first principles, I've got five power principles. One of the first principles is for you to take stock. It's for you to evaluate and assess where you are. I did a very comprehensive broadcast on this principle in September when I was talking about reflection, reflecting on life, work, and relationships. And you can go to my website, royalproclamations.com or whctv.org to view the September broadcast. Don't forget that all the videos are available on demand. And that's the great thing about that, that it's available on demand 24/7. You know, you can access a lot of this broadcast on my website or WHCTV website, and you can review them and you can kind of refresh your memory. But in September, I did a comprehensive teaching on that. And so you can go back to that. But one of the first steps in finishing strong is that you got to take stock. You got to evaluate and assess where you are. Where am I vis-a-vis my dreams? You know, what have I accomplished so far? What remains outstanding? What is yet to be accomplished? You know, so you kind of take stock. And then the next step is to prioritize. Prioritize, okay? The next four principles start with a P. So that's a great way for you to remember. So after you've finished taking stock, you've evaluated, you've assessed, and you've got all of this on paper, the next step is to prioritize. Because if you're like me, there are probably a million and one things you want to accomplish before the year runs to an end. You probably still want to lose weight. You still want to meet your life partner. You want to still close on that deal or that contract. You still want that promotion at work. You know, you still want to find yourself a job if you're unemployed. You know, the list may be endless, but realistically speaking, you got to really prioritize. The reality is that you don't have much time. So you're going to look at what is outstanding and really begin to say to yourself, out of all my to-do list, out of all my wish list, you know, what exactly is it that is so important to me that I must totally accomplish before the year runs out? So you prioritize, you know, and the power of prioritization lies in the fact that it helps you to focus, it would eliminate distraction and help you to better manage the little time that is available in the year. So the first step, like I said, is to take stock, to evaluate and assess where you are. The next step is to prioritize, with a P, prioritize. Out of all those probably conflicting needs and desires and goals and dreams, which one is the most important to you? So you put that down on paper. And then the next principle, the next power principle for finishing strong is to plan. That's the next P. Remember, I said there are going to be four P's after to help you to remember. You have to plan. Remember what Stephen Covey said? To fail to plan is to plan to fail. To fail to plan is to plan to fail. And this is what Princess Bola says. This is what I say. Okay? Failing to have a plan for our dreams makes our dreams merely wishful thinking. If we don't have a plan for our dreams, you're merely wishful thinking. Okay, and I know this is not merely wishful thinking. So you have to create a concrete plan with measurable steps, okay, to help you to finish the year strong. And this measurable steps has to be in place. Otherwise, you would not be able to really move forward and measure the progress you're making. So for example, if one of your high-ranking priorities and goals still remains, for example, is to lose weight, is to lose maybe 20 pounds before the year runs to an end, it's still possible. I mean, you know, with the less than 60 days left, you can still accomplish it. You come up with a plan, and then you say to yourself, over each week, I want to lose 2 pounds. I want to lose 2 pounds. You know, measurable steps. Or, you know, whether if you're looking for a job, for example, you can say every week leading to the end of the year, I'm going to go for at least one job interview. And then so you come up with a plan of how to do that. I'm going to apply to so-and-so organization. I'm going to send my resume here. I'm going to go to this networking meeting or the other, and so on and so forth. And so you have a concrete plan with measurable steps. And where possible, I strongly suggest that you work with a professional. Work with a professional life or business coach. And don't forget that I'm available. It'll be my honor to work with you in this manner. Just go to my website, royalproclamations.com, and connect with me. And, you know, I'll be glad to help you along. So, but, you know, where possible, I really recommend that you work with a professional. Because what a professional will do is to hold you accountable, amongst other things. You know, kind of hold you accountable, and you work out this strategy and this plan with that individual. If you don't, you know, where, you know, if it's not possible for you to work with a professional person, you know, just find a friend, you know, a colleague, a family member, someone that will hold you accountable to that plan, okay? And then, you know, also you commit to the plan. You commit to the plan. You commit to the plan, and then you take action, okay? So it's not just planning and having everything on paper, you know, and drawing that vision and that plan and making it plain, which is very important, and which I shared on the visualization principle in January. You know, I actually took viewers step by step how they can draw up a vision board. You know, so, you know, put the plan and the strategy on your vision board, make it plain, make sure it's somewhere you can see it, where it's visible to you every day. But you then take action. You see, you know, there's no point having it on paper or planning or hoping or wanting to do it if you never really truly take action. Just take the steps, the first steps towards the realization of your dream. So make that phone call, sign up for that weight loss program, go for that next networking meeting. Okay, if you've applied for a job before, apply yet again for that position, you know. Take action, okay? And then that will bring us to the next principle, the next power principle for finishing strong, which is to praise. But before I go into that, let us, you know, kind of quickly look back at what I've talked on so far. We're talking about how to finish strong, how to finish the year 2010 strong. And the message I'm bringing to you is that it's not over till it's over, and it's not over yet. It is still possible for you to finish strong, for you to realize the dreams that you set for yourself at the beginning of the year. It is still a possibility in the less than 60 days that we have to the end of the year. And I'm teaching you the strategies. I'm sharing with you the principles. And one of the first principles is that you take stock, you evaluate, and you assess. Next power principle is you prioritize. Prioritize, prioritize. You can't do it all. Get real. You can't do it all. But you can do one or two and focus on one or two very well, and you can still accomplish it. You can still win. Plan. To fail to plan is to plan to fail. Plan. Come up with a concrete plan with measurable steps. And then you take action, you commit to that plan, you make it plain. And then the fourth power principle is that you praise. And you're thinking, praise? What has God expressing praise got to do with finishing strong? Praise is just about gratitude. You know, it's about gratitude for your accomplishments so far. Okay, I'm sure everyone that's watching this broadcast, that's listening to me, has a testimonial. You have a praise report. There's something that you have accomplished this year, okay? And if you're one of the few people who is thinking, no, I haven't accomplished anything. You know, Princess Bola, 2010 has just been a bad, bad year for me. I haven't made progress in any area of my life whatsoever. Okay, this is your praise report. You are alive. Okay, you're alive and you're live. You're watching me. You're still there. Say, I'm still here. Yes, you're still here. You know, after all, you know, many have passed on and they're no longer here. And for such people, it's really over. You know, there's an adage we say, you know, in my culture, where there's life, there's hope. Where there's life, there's hope. So you're still alive. That's something to be grateful for. Okay. And if you're watching me, that means you have a sound mind. Your mind is still intact, you know, and you can hear and you can listen, you can see. I mean, those are things to be thankful for. So, you know, you praise, you express gratitude for the things that you've accomplished. And this is how gratitude operates. It really helps you to begin to see life from a half glass full perspective, okay? That's a tongue twister. I'll take that again. It really kind of changes your mindset, and you begin to view life from a half glass full perspective. So you're seeing what you have, what is, as opposed to what is not. And that totally just shifts your attitude and your energy and your perspective. And it helps to keep hope alive. Because you're looking at it and say, okay, I accomplished this. Or, you know, like Princess Bola said, I'm still alive. You know, I've got my mind intact. I can still hear. I still have, you know, one or two things going for me. And so that gives me hope, you know, that, you know, if I've come this far, then, you know, I can make it to the finish line, which is what it's all about, what this broadcast is all about, how you can make it to the finish line strongly, okay? So that's how praise operates. It will really change your perspective, your mindset, and your attitude, and your outlook, and it becomes more positive. It will become more hopeful. And do you know what that positive energy and the hopefulness does for you? It's going to attract blessings into your life, okay? It's going to attract those more blessings into your life. You know, negativity and negative energy and depression and despair and the whining that you probably, and the pity party is going to actually work against you. It's going to repel, you know, negative energy repels promise and blessings from you, because if one of your goals is to find your life partner, you know, whoever it is you're trying to get into your life or meet is going to think, I don't think so, because the negative energy is going to kind of just repel, you know. And so it's important to praise, because the praise will help you stay positive, keep your outlook positive, keep hope alive, and really kind of begin to stare, you know, you in the right direction. It will keep you going, because, you know, negativity and despair and depression only just manages to cripple us, to immobilize us from moving forward. So that's what praise does. So take your praise journal, if you keep a journal, a gratitude journal like myself, you know, and just kind of reflect over the year and begin to write down your praise report, your testimonials, and just begin to express gratitude. And plus, you know, this is November, is Thanksgiving month, you know, and so you can take that practice of gratitude, of praise, even to the next step by expressing it to all your clients and your family members and colleagues who've supported you so far, you know, who's, you know, helped you in your journey in 2010, and just say a big thank you. And I want to use that opportunity to say a big thank you to you, my viewers, for tuning in, for your feedback and your support of me, you know, throughout the year. I really do appreciate that. And I want to say, please keep them coming. You know, that's what I kind of feed on myself. You know, people often ask me, you know, Princess Bola, how do you stay so positive? What inspires you? And I say, you know, part of my inspiration comes from my viewers and my clients when they give me that feedback, you know, and tell me how much the broadcast and my programs are really helping them to move forward in life and to achieve their goals. So, you know, keep that coming, and a big thank you. So, you know, express praise, you know, praise. Just be thankful for all that you've accomplished and everything that you are. And it would also kind of open up room for you to be able to receive more. So we've looked at four of the five principles so far, you know, so exciting. And so very practical and so very powerful. And, you know, if we want to recap quickly, number one, you have to take stock, evaluate, and assess where you are in order to finish strong. That's the first and foremost principle, you know, power principle. The next one is that you must prioritize, you know. You must prioritize and, you know, decide which of all of all the outstanding goals that you have is of topmost importance to you. The third power principle is that you must plan. Come up with a concrete plan with measurable steps. If you can work with a professional, work with one, get someone to keep you accountable, you know, and commit to the plan and make it plain, and as well as take action for your plan. And the fourth P we just looked at is praise. Just express gratitude to God also for keeping you alive, and you know, can express gratitude to your family, colleagues, and your clients, and everyone who's kind of just supported you along the way. And it would really kind of just open up, you know, and change your attitude and give you that energy to keep on going on, to keep on keeping on, to persevere, you know, as the year's coming to an end, because you'll be saying to yourself, you know what, if I've accomplished this and I broke through here and I did accomplish that, then, you know, hey, you know, who says that I can't accomplish much more in less than 60 days? And the final P principle to finishing strong is pray. Yes, I said pray. And I know for some of you, you're thinking, you know, I can't believe she said that. You know, what has prayer got to do with it? A lot. For me, a lot. I'm a firm believer in the power of prayer. Trust me, take this one from me. It works. Okay? Pray, 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 pray. I'm telling you. And prayer does work. And this is how prayer operates. Prayer is your invitation. You're inviting God, the supernatural, the divine, to intervene in your circumstances. You're giving God permission. God is a gentleman, and I don't think he gate crashes into our lives. You know, he's giving us free will, and so, you know, we have to invite him to come on the scene. And when you pray, what you're saying is and doing is giving God permission to come on the scene. Okay, and he comes with his supernatural power and begin to work the circumstances in your favor. Okay, you can't make it all happen, you know. And, you know, when you pray, you just find that also you're more open to inspiration and wisdom and guidance. And you just find yourself at the right place, at the right time, doing the right thing and meeting the right people. I'm telling you, it works for me. Like I said, I believe so much in prayer. I'm a woman of prayer. And I remember that, you know, I had one or two or three goals like everybody else for the year. And, you know, one of my goals was to, for an event I have upcoming, to really have a big sponsor. And I remember after prayer one morning, I had this strong feeling and desire to go for a networking meeting. And a lot of these meetings sometimes are way too early for me anyway, because I'm juggling so much. But, you know, I had this strong impression, I couldn't shake it off, that I should go for this meeting. And voila, I did. And I met, you know, the general manager of a huge upscale departmental store. And I was able to connect and get sponsorship for my event. You know, and that's what prayer does. I believe that if I hadn't prayed that morning, I wouldn't have had that strong desire to go, and I'd have probably missed out on that opportunity. So that's how prayer works. It kind of just helps to position you. You are led. Your steps are ordered. You know, you're more sensitive. You're more creative. You get divine guidance and wisdom. God steps into your situation and begins to kind of move the circumstances and work it out in your favor. And prayer does work. So pray, 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 pray. I would say pray, pray. And you know what? What this principle reminds me of is a song we used to sing in Sunday school. You know, and I don't have the best voice, but I'm going to sing it very quickly. And it says, what a friend we have in Jesus. Okay? What a friend we have in Jesus. All our griefs and sins to bear. What a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. And this is my favorite part. Oh, what peace we often forfeit. Oh, what needless pain we bear. All because we do not carry everything to God in prayer. You see? Yeah. Oh, what needless pain we bear. Oh, what peace we often forfeit. Oh, what blessings and breakthrough, all because we do not pray. So those are the five power principles. I'm a living testimonial that they work. I've applied them in my life, and I must say to you, 2010 so far has been a great year for me. One of the goals was to increase my revenue by, you know, getting more corporate clients to work with. I got that this year. I got that breakthrough. My second goal was to organize a mega conference or event to empower women and to reach a diverse audience. I accomplished that. You know, one of my goals and high ranking goals was to really revamp my website to make it more interactive, more resourceful, more informational, you know, and voila, I just awarded the contract and it's being worked on. And so you can look forward by the end of November, go to royalproclamations.com. My website will be totally, you know, just brand new. It's overhauled. You can leave me messages. I have a message board. You can post testimonials. We can continue to have conversation. So, and these are the principles that I put into place. And, you know, you can apply them. Take stock, okay? Prioritize, plan, praise, and pray. And you will make it across the finish line in this year, in the last few days left in this year, strong, happy, fulfilled, and having reached your dreams. Next month is December, and I have a great show for you as usual. So make sure you tune in and invite a friend as well to tune in to the broadcast. I'm going to be talking about looking back in 2010, what 2010 has taught you, and looking forward to 2011, how to implement the lessons that 2010 taught you. It's a really very interesting program that I have lined up for you. As well as, don't forget that you can connect with me on Facebook. Just search for Princess Bola Adelani, LinkedIn, Twitter. I'm on most of or all of the social networking sites. And also, you can go to my website, royalproclamations.com, to sign up for my newsletter and to stay in the loop, you know, with all my offerings and, you know, all the other powerful programs that I have for work-life success, training, coaching, speaking programs. This is Princess Bola Adelani reminding you to keep smiling, you know, like I always share, put a smile on your face. Hey, the world hasn't come to an end. Keep believing, keep learning, keep networking, keep on keeping on. I'll see you next month. Thank you so much for tuning in. God bless. And you will finish strong.